Hello and welcome to the virtual open house for Bergen County Technical High School in Teterboro. We would like to begin by telling you a little about our school. 20 years ago, Bergen Tech Teterboro was a shared-time vocational school. We focused on some of the more traditional vocations, including plumbing, welding, and cosmetology. Through the hard work and dedication of our teachers, students, and administrators, we've evolved into an entirely full-time high school with vocations that better represent our world today. Currently, we are a highly competitive vocational public school. Due to our small size, we are only able to accept about 170 of the nearly 1,400 applicants we receive each year. We've been nationally recognized as one of the best schools in the country, as a 2012 Blue Ribbon School of Excellence. U.S. News and World Report again ranked us as a gold medal high school, placing us 58th in a list of over 19,000 schools, making us well within the top 1% of schools around the country. We are third in the state of New Jersey, ranked in New Jersey's top 5 schools for the 6th year running. We are also consistently listed as a top school by Newsweek magazine. Bergen Tech was honored as an Apple Distinguished School. Last year, students took nearly 900 AP exams. Dual enrollment college credits were awarded for our classes over 400 times last year. Our students have won awards for art, writing, and music. They place in national science and math competitions, they're athletes, and they serve our community. We enroll about 650 students coming from over 50 school districts, both public and private, across the county. We are a full-time high school that follows a traditional school day from 8 a.m. to 3 p.m., divided into 9 periods. All students are enrolled in the same academic classes, regardless of technical area. Our curriculum is aligned to the New Jersey Student Learning Standards, Common Core, and Next Generation Science Standards. Our teachers are AP certified and are certified in the current standards for their technical areas. We have a number of articulations with various colleges and universities. So, in addition to AP credits, students can earn college credits from Fairleigh Dickinson University, New Jersey Institute of Technology, Syracuse University, and Bergen County Community College. Our graduation requirements are listed above. Most students go above and beyond the minimum requirements, taking additional years of science and math, world language, and additional classes in the social sciences. As the years progress, students also spend more periods each day in their technical areas. Our school offers a number of advanced placement classes. Students enrolled in these courses take an exam at the end of the school year, and they can receive college credit for the class. We offer AP classes in most subject areas. Last year, our students took 918 exams. As freshmen entering our school, all students take the same English, physics, and physical education classes. Students select one of our world languages to study, and they are enrolled in their technical area for 1 period a day. We offer a placement test in the spring, which determines whether the student will take global studies or be offered AP Human Geography. Likewise, the placement test determines the math class or classes that the student will take. Our 9 technical areas or majors are listed here. They include aerospace engineering, automotive engineering and design, commercial art and graphic design, computer science, culinology, digital media arts, fashion design and merchandising, law and justice, and strategic asset management. Here is a brief introduction.
Welcome to Bergen Tech's Aerospace Program. This is a major designed for students who are interested in solving problems and seeing solutions come to life. We work through the basic concepts of engineering in the design process, equipping students to think like engineers, systematically break down problems, brainstorming innovative ways of solving problems both here on the ground and up in the sky, learning how to work both independently and in teams, on projects such as taking part in robotics challenges and competitions, mimicking alien terrain, developing a payload for a balloon launch, monitoring atmospheric conditions, capturing video and photos of Earth. You will leave here with the confidence to navigate the shop in order to bring life to your design solutions. All courses lead to a senior year capstone where students work on an entire year solving a problem of their choice, leaving with an experiential knowledge and comfort with the engineering design process. So if you like science, if you like math, if you like building stuff, this is the place for you.
In automotive engineering design, the students will be immersed in the design process from the ground up. On their journey, they will become expert critical thinkers and problem solvers. Starting with the basics of automotive technology and engineering design, the students work their way through project-based courses and get hands-on experience in the automotive shop. As they progress through the curriculum, students will learn about the ever-growing world of electric and hybrid vehicles, as well as the communication systems that link everything in the modern car. Students will have the opportunity to work with electric vehicle kits, as well as explore autonomous driving vehicles with a great lab designed by Rutgers College. With partners like Jaguar, the students will see and analyze cutting-edge vehicle technology and how engineers have improved the designs throughout the years. The curriculum culminates in a senior capstone project where the students get to design and showcase the skills they have acquired throughout their time at BT.
Welcome to Commercial Art and Graphic Design at Bergen County Technical High School in Teterboro, New Jersey. I'm Bridget Centeno. I'm an art director, graphic designer, and illustrator, and I'd like to tell you a little bit more about our program. Commercial art, also referred to as graphic design, is the art of creative services. Our program primarily focuses on areas such as fine art and design, communication, as well as marketing and branding. The intention of the Commercial Art and Graphic Design program at the Teterboro campus is that all students will have an in-depth knowledge of fine art, visualization, and media. Students study essential aspects of the commercial art field through a college-level curriculum. This curriculum embraces new technology while emphasizing principles of art and design and a consistent focus on creativity and creative thinking. Studio classes include art history, fine art, graphic design, multimedia design, web design, and advertising and marketing. Students engage in real-world curriculum that is driven by high expectations, fine art and computer graphics instruction, and professional working atmosphere. All students are required to create and maintain a portfolio that exhibits a high degree of creativity as well as technical proficiency. With Bergen County Technical High School's proximity to New York City, the creative epicenter of the world, students have access to internships in hundreds of production houses that support the art and imaging needs of prestigious area businesses. Our program is articulated through Kane University, and many of our students go on to be successful in their chosen design field. If you're interested in any other information about our program, please visit our website, bergentechdesign.com.
Computer science is taught by Ms. Rogalskaya, Ms. Friedman, and Mr. Jamichi. The computer science major is broken down into different material that's taught during all 4 years. Ninth grade coursework includes Intro to Object-Oriented Design. 10th grade coursework includes Intermediate Programming and AP Computer Science Principles. 11th grade coursework includes Advanced Programming and Networking 1. 12th grade coursework includes Intro to Cybersecurity and Cloud Computing and Financial Literacy. In addition, 12th grade coursework includes SUPA Introduction to Computing and Mobile App Development. You can access the Computer Science Flyer by pausing this video and scanning the QR code. Perks of being in the computer science major include internship opportunities, hands-on experience, excelling with electronics, which is useful in other subjects and classes. You can earn college credits, have fun with gaming, and learn financial literacy, which is included along with developmental business soft skills. Computer science degrees can be applied to a variety of different fields, including artificial intelligence, computer security, software engineering, and computer networking. Computing jobs are the number one source of new wages in the United States. Technology affects every field in business and in day-to-day lives. Different careers that involve computer technology include biotechnology, applied mathematics, e-commerce, chemistry, finance and business, graphic design, music, healthcare, and law. Women who try computer science in high school are 10 times more likely to major in it in college.
Welcome to our open house. We posed a question to our culinology students as to why they love culinology. And this is probably why you will love culinology too.
I like culinology because I really like food, and I like how we get to try what we made at the end, because I think it's important not only to learn how to make certain things, but also to try what we just made. And I also like how culinology incorporates the science aspect, so we take classes such as nutrition, food chemistry, and microbiology of food. I think the restaurants that are held at the end of the year are very interesting as well. It is challenging, but I think it's great that we're able to have real life experience, because participating in the restaurant really feels like we're actually working at a real life restaurant.
I like culinology because it gives us the opportunity to make foods that we can't usually make at home, and we can make it at school.
My favorite thing would definitely have to be how everything is hands-on, and you really get to just like cook on your own and like bake, and like the chefs just give you, like, they tell you what to do and they give you the recipes and you just do it. And I just think that's really cool because it's a whole different way of learning.
I love culinology because I can express my creative side and test out new recipes with new ingredients, new flavors, and learn so much about the world around me, like the different foods that are in this world, different cultural foods, ethnic foods. I love being in the kitchen, experimenting, learning from the chefs, and working together collaboratively with friends. And really, it's a fun experience every day. You'll never get bored.
The reason why I like culinary is because, first, you get to make amazing food. All the food you make tastes good, and you get to learn how to cook it, which is good, especially if you get hungry on the weekends and stuff, and there's nothing to eat in your house, or you don't have ingredients. You learn how to make dishes, and good ones at that. Second, the chefs are really chill, nice people, and you learn a lot.
We learn not only cooking and baking, but we also get to learn the science behind it in microbiology, nutrition, and food chem.
I really like Chef B, and I really enjoy what he teaches us. I just love learning new things to cook and making it at home.
It's a very good thing to know how to cook for yourself, to cook for the people around you, and how to work around certain allergies that people have in your family or among your friends. And it can definitely help balance your skills and make you grow as a person.
We get to learn the diversity of the cooking industry.
We're the only major in the school with cool hats.
And I think my favorite part about the class is working with other people, because we all get to share the same experience of cooking foods, and we all get to try different things together, and I feel like it just brings us together as a major. It's overall just a great experience, and I've learned so much from that class.
You also can't forget about how amazing both the two chefs are.
I can express my creativity through the palette of food. And I feel like it's a good way to connect with your cultural background, because then through food, you learn more about where you come from.
I get to wear the chef hat. No, but seriously, like, I love it because it's a life skill, and I always look forward to cooking or baking with my friends at the end of the day. And I love making all these good foods in my class. And once you guys go back to the school, I hope you guys will have as much fun as I did in the kitchen.
It's a real team building process, and that's what I love most about it.
Thank you for attending, and have a great day.
Welcome to digital media. Digital media is a major that includes many subjects, including 2D graphics and animation, 3D animation, video production, audio production, photography, desktop publishing, and broadcast journalism. Mr. Miller has been teaching digital media since 2002, and since he wrote the major, he can easily change the direction and pace to fit the needs of any student or class. Students spend 4 years working with state-of-the-art equipment and software that meets or exceeds what can be found in professional studios around the world. Our video studio is used for live broadcasts such as our morning news and also for other student video productions. We are in the middle of an upgrade that will include a far more powerful control room, 4K cameras, and new LED lighting. The main classroom is filled with Macs and are loaded with the latest versions of industry standard programs including Adobe Photoshop, Illustrator, InDesign, Animate, Fireworks, Dreamweaver, Muse, Audition, Premiere, and After Effects. We also have audio programs such as Logic Pro and Pro Tools, and 3D animation programs such as Cinema 4D and Maya, which is one of the main animation programs used in Hollywood and film studios around the world. Studio A is a video studio, a photography studio, and a fully functional audio studio for recording, mixing, and mastering. All of the studios are very well stocked with plenty of still cameras, video cameras, lights, microphones, mixer, and speakers. Since the studios are at opposite ends of the classroom, students can work on simultaneous large projects in the separate spaces. We can have students doing a live broadcast, taking photographs, editing pictures or video, mixing music, and have none of them getting in the way of each other. The environment is intimate and comfortable and is conducive to individual creativity as well as group projects. Students are able to work at their own pace and turn their ideas and imagination into tangible works of art. We regularly work with other departments in the school and clients in a real-world environment that gives students a true taste of what a career in media arts will involve, but with the safety nets you would expect to find in a high school classroom. Students are in class for one period a day as freshmen and two periods a day as sophomores, juniors, and seniors. There is no portfolio needed, no home computer or software requirements, and no experience necessary. Everything the students need to succeed will be provided. Students with no experience will be comfortably guided, and students with prior experience will be challenged and able to channel that experience into new creative outlets.
Giving form and function to clothing, Bergen County Technical High School's fashion, design, and merchandising program expresses itself in the language of style, ever-changing in harmony with the attitudes of the time and fundamental human need. With increasing high-end computer interfaces, students experiment with design concepts and patterns before turning ideas into fashion statements that continue to move the industry forward into a new visual and practical territory. Our fashion design program is a fully equipped design studio wherein students acquire a broad overview as well as an introduction into design fundamentals, discovering the challenging intricacies of the fashion design, merchandising, and marketing workflow. Students learn and experiment their way through the study of color and textiles, fashion illustrations, pattern making, and sewing skills as they transform their design concepts into creating and producing high fashion couture garments. Areas of study include fashion illustration, 2D and 3D design, basic and advanced sewing and construction, textile sciences, apparel production and management, fashion merchandising and marketing, and digital fashion art and portfolio development. Some of our program's highlights also include our yearly student exhibit at the Belsky Museum in Closter, New Jersey, annual fashion show extravaganza presented by the fashion design students at the end of each year, and our community outreach programs with Progressive Comprehensive Services, a rehabilitation center for enhancing abilities, a New Jersey division of developmental disabilities self-directed real-life choice programs, wherein our students design and develop a clothing line for their clients. With academic achievement and high performance in fashion design, graduates are well qualified and placed into world-renowned fashion design institutes, colleges, and universities, such as Fashion Institute of Technology, Cornell, Marist College, Rhode Island School of Design, Parsons, LIM, Pratt, SCAD, Philadelphia School of Art, and London School of Fashion.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Anthony Zing. I'm a senior in the Law and Justice major at Bergen Tech, and welcome to our virtual open house for the Law and Justice major. So what is the Law and Justice major? Well, at its most base, the Law and Justice major serves as a preparation for students interested in legal, government, and public safety professions, though it's by no means limited to students interested in these fields. It provides a baseline understanding of the systems that ensure social stability, and seeks to give students the necessary skills to become leaders in law and related fields. In ninth grade, you'll be taking a class called Intro to Law and Justice. It's a general overview of what law is. You'll be learning about the many facets of law, you'll be learning about the general vocabulary you'll need for the next 3 years, and you'll be dabbling in both criminal and civil law. Moving to 10th grade, you'll begin to specialize a bit more. You'll be taking classes called AP Government and Constitutional Law, which are exactly as they sound. AP Government, you'll be learning about the United States government, and in Constitutional Law, you'll be learning about the United States Constitution. As you move into 11th grade, you'll be taking classes called SUPA Public Policy and Criminology. In SUPA Public Policy, you'll be learning about how policymakers come up with and implement their policy solutions. To do this, you'll be going around Bergen County interviewing various policymakers. And in Criminology, you'll be learning about how the mind of a criminal functions, a very enticing class for those of you interested in criminal law. In 12th grade, you'll be taking classes called SUPA Forensics and Senior Seminar. SUPA Forensics introduces you to the basics of police work, a very interesting class regardless of what field you're interested in. And Senior Seminar introduces you to the financial world as well as general legal advice. So now that we've gone over the more boring stuff, let's head into the fun stuff. What are some program highlights of the Law and Justice major? Well, as you may have noticed in the previous slide, there are several classes preceded with the word SUPA, S-U-P-A. Well, these indicate college-level courses in partnership with Syracuse University, which, though they are provided at reduced tuition, are actually weighted the same as college-level courses you would take at the university level. In addition, Law and Justice also helps you develop important soft skills. Things like shaking a hand, conducting an interview, writing a resume, all of these things that you need in the corporate world are things that the Law and Justice major will help prepare you for. In addition, we have something called the Annual Freshman Sophomore Law Debate, something which is always interesting for anyone interested in law. And we also have field trips, whether it be to the Bergen County Courthouse or to Washington, D.C. These are all locations that our law teachers have generously found for us, which are always interesting. But you didn't think that was all, did you? Some more program highlights include great internships. Whether you're interested in politics or law in general, have you covered? Great internships in the Law and Justice major that immediately come to mind are things like a legal internship at BMW International's legal department and various political internships all over Bergen County. This is in addition to academic research opportunities, mostly provided in our SUPA Public Policy class, where you'll be researching your own public policy and you'll be presenting to policymakers at our annual symposium. We also provide access to a professional network in the fields of law, government, and public safety, and our senior year capstone trip to Washington, D.C. is actually partially a research and networking event where you'll be interviewing policymakers in our nation's capital. I'm sure you don't want to hear me droning on for a couple more minutes, so let's head into our Law and Justice scrapbook and see just what a Law and Justice experience is really like.
But before we go on to appreciate some pictures from our various field trips, I'd like to first welcome the Bergen Tech Law and Justice Class of 2024. So to those of you who are part of this Law and Justice class, I welcome you to the Law and Justice major and Bergen Tech as a whole. And so to those of you out there watching this video, we'd like to formally invite you to the Law and Justice major. Give it a chance. We guarantee you won't be disappointed. Have a great day, and good luck.
Welcome to the Strategic Asset Management Program, that is fondly referred to as SAM. This program explores the integral component of any comprehensive investment planning process. The program is designed to explore investment strategies driven by unique sets of investment goals. Asset allocation is at the core of strategic asset management. This involves spreading investments across several asset classes, such as stocks, bonds, and cash equivalents to reflect financial goals. Asset allocation allows a portfolio to participate in a variety of market sectors to potentially minimize overall volatility. This program provides the technical and analytical skills necessary to understand how financial markets function and how businesses operate and make decisions within these markets. This major will prepare you to understand the financial industry, whether in financial institutions or in government or nonprofit institutions. Note that the material in the courses is intended to build upon previous courses and becomes more sophisticated in the upperclassmen years. We look forward to seeing you all in September and wish you luck on your entrance exam. As high school progresses, students gain more knowledge in their technical areas. This has culminated with the senior internship. Students go out of the building on Wednesdays to participate in their chosen internship. This enables students to enter the workforce and gain additional experience in their fields. Some students choose to pursue internships related to their technical area. Other students use their internship as a time to pursue new interests. You can see some of the many places that students have worked. We have students working at the Museum of Natural History in New York and closer to home at Hackensack University Medical Center and at the Bergen County Courthouse. This year, one of our seniors is interning at the S&P Dow Jones. Our students are working with architects, web designers, stockbrokers, engineers, nonprofits, and designers. We have many of the same activities as a regular high school. Some of the clubs we offer are listed above. We have a student council and a chapter of the National Honor Society. Our drama club puts on a production every spring, and we have various service clubs. There is an after-school late bus which runs on club days that students can take home. We have an outstanding music teacher, Mr. Rojek, who teaches our chorus, band, and guitar classes, with evening recitals during the year. In addition to classes, we have many extracurricular music events for singers and musicians. Everyone is welcome to participate, whether or not they are enrolled in classes. We participate in a number of athletic programs together with the other high schools in our district. Our team is the Knights. Our colors are black and gold, and we are members of the New Jersey Interscholastic Athletic Association, Big North Conference, Liberty Division. You can see that we participate in the usual fall sports. We have football, soccer, cross country, volleyball, and cheerleading. In the winter, we have basketball, bowling, cheerleading, and fencing, and boys and girls indoor track. We also have pep rallies for our sports teams during the year. In the spring, we have baseball, softball, track, tennis, golf, and lacrosse. This year, we have started our one-to-one initiative. Every ninth grader receives an iPad with an Apple Pencil and combo case with Wi-Fi keyboard. Students are required to use their iPad and school-managed Apple ID. So, I'd like to take a short break and show you a little video about school life here at Bergen Tech.
Running, running, and 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 running, running, and
in this context, there's no disrespect, so when I bust my rhyme, you break your necks. We got 5 minutes for us to disconnect from all intellect and let the rhythm affect. Lose the inhibition, follow your intuition, free your inner soul and break away from tradition. Everybody, yeah. Everybody, yeah. Let's get into it, yeah. Get stoked, get it started, get it started, yeah. Get it started, yeah. Let's get it started, ha. Let's get it started, in here, let's get it started, ha. Let's get it started, in here, yeah. Ooh. Lose control, a body and soul, don't move too fast, people just take it slow, don't get ahead, just jump into it. Y'all hear about it? The P's will do it. Get started, get stupid. Don't worry about it, people will walk you through it step by step like an infant new kid. Inch by inch with a new solution. Transmit hits with no delusion. The feeling's irresistible and that's how we move it. Yo.
Everybody, yeah. Everybody, yeah. Let's get into it. Yeah. Get stupid, I'm out. Get started, I'm out. Get started, yeah. Get started.
The time you can't stand still, just and bang your spine. Just bob your head like me, Apple D, up inside your club or in your Bentley. Get messy, loud and sick. Your mind fast, normal on another head trip. So,
everybody, yeah. Everybody, yeah. Let's get into it. Yeah. Get stoked,
I'm on.
Get started,
I'm on.
Get started,
get started.
Let's get it started. Ha. Let's get it started.
In here,
let's get it started.
Ha.
Let's get it started.
We hope you liked the video, which was put together by our digital media students. We also have some students this evening to tell you a little about Bergen Tech in their own words.
Hi, my name is Jenna, and I'm a junior in culinary. Going to Bergen Tech has completely changed my life and allowed me to grow into the person I am today. Of course, leaving your hometown school district, leaving your friends and loved ones, and stepping out of your comfort zone may be scary, but I can assure you that Bergen Tech will welcome you with open arms. In the past 3 years, I've met some of the most amazing friends and made lifelong memories in the halls of Bergen Tech. Bergen Tech has allowed my peers and I to have endless opportunities that my district town would most definitely not provide. Although the courses are rigorous, it has forced me to become better at time management, organization, and I know that I will be well prepared for my future. As a student, I know that by the end of my 4 years, I will be leaving Bergen Tech with much more than just a diploma. I will be leaving with life skills, a higher education, and the most incredible people that I'm lucky enough to call my friends. Last year, I made the wonderful decision to join one of Bergen Tech's most popular clubs called Lemon Club. In Lemon Club, all the profits we make go to Alex's Lemonade Stand, a nonprofit organization that donates to childhood cancer research. Joining last year was definitely one of the best choices I made and has allowed me to participate in something outside of school. Joining a club, especially as an underclassman, is really beneficial and allows you to meet upperclassmen. Lemon Club is a really rewarding club, and you're honestly surrounded by just an incredible group of people. Knowing that I'm giving back to the community and helping fight childhood cancer is a great feeling, and without Bergen Tech, I would have never been able to be a part of something so great.
Hi, my name is Sharon. I'm a junior in the computer science major. I think one of the best decisions I've made in life was choosing Bergen Tech, specifically computer science. Bergen Tech will give you opportunities that you couldn't have imagined at your district high school. Although I've been at BT for only 2 years, I believe that this school has already begun preparing me for college and higher education. Coming to BT is like opening a new chapter. You don't have to worry about anything. You just have to go with the flow and believe in yourself. On the first day of school, I remember walking into the building, thinking about how hard it's going to be to adjust to the new environment and make new friends. Soon enough, I realized that I worried for nothing. Everyone was new, everyone was open to making new friends. It didn't get any easier. Leaving my friends from district and coming to BT was hard. But after meeting people here, I was left with zero regrets. If there's one thing I learned about my experiences at BT, it's that building good relationships is key to success. The kids in your major will become more than your friends. They'll be family. Trust me, I'm saying this because virtual learning began a couple of months before the end of my sophomore year. Now that I think about it, I really miss the fun and laughter we had in our class. Despite the heavy workload, the teachers at BT are very helpful. They're willing to help and guide you in the right direction. Unlike other high schools, teachers at BT do not spoon-feed students. It may sound hard having to do work yourself, but being able to study and learn yourself is a must-have quality in college. One thing I'm really happy about BT is how helpful and understanding the upperclassmen are. They're always open to telling you what they did right and wrong and what they regret in their previous years. It's sort of like you have the chance to do better and not repeat mistakes and not make regrets later in life. I don't think I could have or can survive my high school years if it weren't for my teachers and friends, especially upperclassmen. Bergen Tech is more than just a high school. It's a place to have fun, connect, and build better relationships with people of different backgrounds to prepare you for the outside world. Thank you.
Welcome, all parents and students. My name is Kamal Jings. I'm a freshman at Bergen County Technical School, Teterboro. I remember the open house last year. I was in your shoes. I knew I was interested the second I walked into the building. Now I'm able to take advantage of the academic opportunities this school offers. My first weeks of high school have been wonderful. We are currently virtual and can't meet with fellow students and staff in person. However, my classmates and teachers have been very polite and supportive. I'm looking forward to the day we return to school. I'm excited to learn about so many new things. I'm also confident that my major, automotive engineering design, will teach me many things about engineering and solving real-world problems, as engineering is something I want to pursue in college. I wish all students good luck, thank you for your time, and I hope to see some of you guys next year in person at this school.
Hello everyone, my name is Queenie Michelle Sarajan, and I am currently a junior in the Law and Justice major here at Bergen County Technical High School in Teterboro. Coming to Bergen Tech has opened up opportunities for me emotionally, educationally, and socially. Prior to being a student here, I was always a last minute person. I did my homework on the mornings they were due, and I wrote essays two hours before their deadline. However, through coming to this school, I learned how to time manage and prioritize because I realized that when I grow up and join the workforce, procrastination has no place there. Another major thing that I've learned as a product of being a law student and having Mrs. Allard as one of my teachers is how to become a better public speaker. Before having Mrs. Allard, I was a very confident public speaker, but I spoke extremely quick, so my points never got, across and it was never perceived correctly. However, Mrs. Allard taught me how to slow down, speak audibly, and balance my cadence, skills that I'm using right now as I speak to you through the screen, unfortunately, because of Corona. However, these are all skills that I'm very, very grateful that I have learned and acquired, along with all the other social soft skills that I learned as being a law student, skills that I can use in the future when it comes to job interviews and conducting meetings. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Lana. I'm a freshman at Bergen County Technical High School. I moved to my town Paramus about 5 years ago, and it was extremely difficult to transition to the new middle school, which is why I was quite apprehensive on my first day of high school, especially when having to do it over Zoom. Although what frightened me the most was the idea that I was going to attend one of the most prestigious high schools in New Jersey. Once I finally finished my first day in the school, I was astonished by the amount of effort put into making the educational experience of the students less stressful. My AP Human Geography teacher told my class that the school did not want his students to stress over excessive workload and made sure that his students would not receive an unreasonable amount of homework. The school even issued individual sessions with students in order to discuss the current amount of work they receive and if the workload made them stressed at all. This school has certainly made it a priority to give their students the most stress-free environment possible. I am majoring in strategic asset management, and my teacher has been making her class extremely stress-free. We start this class period off by discussing how stock industries have behaved over the course of the day and begin talking about news and current events that could possibly affect the market. Ms. Sphere, my major teacher, was going to assign our first assessment but pushed the date by a few days because we asked for more practice. The class is very fascinating in the sense that the students are able to learn without having to worry about too much work or grades. My experience in Bergen Tech has been very exciting, motivating, and most of all, stress-free.
My name is Sham, and I'm a sophomore in commercial art here in Bergen Tech. Bergen Tech really helped me improve not only as a student, but as a person too. With engaging students and teachers, I was able to strive for my full potential, which I don't think I could have done if I was in my district school. Some may say that there is a lot of stress and workload, but Bergen Tech supports you with great stress managing programs like meditation apps and yoga classes, which personally helped me a lot. It helps you cope and manage stress, and Bergen Tech also offers great programs, clubs, and majors, which is really helpful for college applications. Personally, I learned how to manage my time and met some of the best people who share the same interest. Although it is challenging school, if you're willing to put the work in, Bergen Tech is a great way to start your new journey to success.
Greetings, students, parents, and guardians. My name is James Vargas, and I am a ninth grader currently attending the Bergen County Technical High School in the Teterboro campus. This year especially, we have all had to learn, adapt, and persevere. However, even through virtual learning, BCT has made me feel not only welcome, but at home. I feel so fortunate to already have such amiable, supportive, and not to mention hilarious teachers who somehow are able to brighten up my day every day. Not only this, but it is evident that teachers and staff at BCT care not only for my education as well as the education of my peers, but our physical and psychological well-being as much as we do ourselves. Students even get access to wellness and mindfulness programs completely cost-free and provided for by the school, such as Headspace and Floop. I always feel encouraged to experiment, participate, and learn in the safe environment that my school provides. There is a place for everyone at BT with an immensely diverse student body that is also accepting and encouraging of your individuality. This, in conjunction with the numerous clubs and sports one can join and participate in, such as the Bitcoin Club, Ski Club, Super Smash Bros. Club, Drama Club, National Junior Honor Society, football, baseball, soccer, tennis, volleyball, basketball, cross country, weightlifting, and cheer, just to name a few. There are so many opportunities for students and staff alike to develop teamwork skills, explore their other passions, gain new experiences, and make new friends. Furthermore, through my major of digital media with Mr. Miller, I have been pursuing my passion and learning how to develop and cultivate this same passion and creative drive into a skill in a manner which is effective, fulfilling, and enjoyable. I know, I still have a lot left to learn and plenty of mistakes left to make, but I'm glad I chose Teterboro as the guide for my journey. Join us and you will agree that the best awaits you at BCT.
Hello, my name is Asya Arif. I'm a freshman here at BT, and my major is aerospace engineering. I find my education to be vital and an aspect of my life that I'm in full control of. I wanted my years at high school to benefit my disposition and my career. Even though I've only experienced a couple weeks of online school, I can tell that there's a massive difference between what's being prioritized. All of the courses I take each have their own character, and surprise, surprise, teacher. I like to experience ideologies from individual mentors so that I can build upon my own. I therefore put myself in an environment where both students and teachers want to work with each other to understand topics on a new level. My math analysis class is much different from my global studies class, as is my English class from my physics class. Nonetheless, they all aim for the same thing. If you were to take a sneak peek into my global studies class, you'd notice something strange from the first couple of minutes. We have barely learned any history at all. Instead, we are learning theories. We are learning about historiography and how we can apply that. Ms. Mancini often encourages us to be mindful through meditation and exercise. So far, we have been able to understand Allegory of the Cave by Plato and have already begun to apply it to Fahrenheit 451 by Ray Bradbury, which was our summer reading. BT prioritizes their students to not just make them better people, but better entrepreneurs, coders, designers, cooks, engineers. The list goes on. So, if you're interested in being challenged, come join us at Bergen Tech.
What do you want to be when you grow up? At some point in everyone's lives, they have been faced with this question. As an eighth grader who wanted to apply to Bergen Tech last year, I was not able to answer it like most adolescents. However, I've always been interested in the law department. Bergen Tech is the perfect school if you're finding a way to be exposed to a specific major while also receiving an advanced education. So far, I've been introduced to a numerous amount of information in my major that public schools and other private schools will not be able to offer. My name is Renee Enon, and I'm currently a freshman at Bergen Tech in the Law and Justice program. About a year ago today, I remember walking through the doors of this very campus. It's almost as if I could still feel the racing of my heartbeat and the excitement that ran through my body. Bergen Tech has always been a dream school of mine. After going to the open house and being able to see the environment, I knew I belonged here. Unfortunately, we're undergoing rough circumstances and cannot be all together here today. Even though I was not able to encounter a first typical day of high school, Bergen Tech has made my first ninth grade experience unforgettable. I was anxious that the transition from middle school to high school would be very complex and stressful during this virtual period, especially because I was not familiar with the other students. Nonetheless, I made many friends through athletics and other activities. I spent a large amount of my time with teammates throughout the summer for summer workouts and during practice. The team gave me an opportunity to make connections with students from Bergen County Technical Schools. Also, the staff, administration, teachers, and counselors have been very considerate and supportive. Bergen Tech might assist you in answering this controversial question by giving you the opportunity to take advantage of all the resources provided. I hope you decide to become a part of this collaborative and cohesive community.
Hello everyone, I am a current senior in the automotive major here at Bergen Tech. Within these walls, Bergen Tech is not just a school, but it is a family. It is filled with teachers who want nothing but to assist you in your journey to success hereafter and peers who make your everyday brighter. BT has been a major asset in my educational journey, of course, but what I think hits home for me the most is that it has assisted my personal journey. I've met some amazing friends and teachers who taught and continue to teach me lessons beyond just the books. I've been able to understand my own intellect and sort through the confusing tangles of my future due to the passion and love spread through the halls of BT. Something specific that I learned that I would like to share with you guys from my journey here at Bergen Tech is to not let anyone underestimate you. As cheesy as it sounds, it really is something to consider. As a female applying to the automotive major, a field dominated by men, I was told from people outside of the Bergen Tech environment that this probably wasn't the best decision for me to have made, as I would be getting my hands dirty and working with boys. In fact, my class proved otherwise, accepting a ratio of boys to girls that was just about equal. It doesn't matter who you are or what you want to accomplish, as long as you can keep your mindset on what your path is and surround yourself with people who will support you through it all, you don't need anything more. I thank you all for your time, and I hope that Bergen Tech is a school you would consider applying to. Bye-bye.
By now, hopefully, you're all excited about Bergen Tech and you want to apply. The question we are often asked is, what exactly is the admissions committee looking for? Essentially, Each student is applying against nearly 1,400 other students for one of 170 places in the freshman class. I can't stress enough to you how competitive this process is. Admissions decisions are based on the student's choice of major. Your first choice major is considered more strongly than your second choice. Most of the students that apply to our school have A averages. We look at your PARC NJSLA scores as part of the admissions process, and all applicants take an admissions test that contains a math and a writing section. We look at teacher recommendations and the student's application essay. If a student has an IEP or 504 plan, we review that as well. Students applying for commercial art do have an additional portfolio requirement, and their portfolio is considered when we make our decisions. Information about the portfolio can be found on our website. The admissions committee looks at all of these factors together and selects the strongest students that have applied for each major. This year, all applicants will take a virtual admissions test. The admissions test has two sections. The math section allows students 1 hour to answer 40 questions, and the writing section allows 40 minutes to read and respond to a passage. Sample questions are posted on both the Teterboro and Hackensack admissions webpages. Please know that there are various organizations selling preparatory materials and courses. None of these have been evaluated by or endorsed by our district. Our only recommendation is to prepare by looking at the sample questions. The application will be available online starting October 12th. Our application process is entirely online. We accept no paper applications. First, you will need to download, print, and read the instruction manual. Next, you will need to register on the application website. When you register, you will need your smart ID number to proceed. This is a unique 10-digit number assigned to all public school students in New Jersey. Most likely, you do not know this number and will have to ask your school counselor. They can provide it to you. Alternately, it is printed on the upper left corner of your PARC NJSLA score report. Many of the grade reporting programs like PowerSchool, Genesis, and RealTime have a place for the ID number to be entered as well. Students who attend private school or are homeschooled do not have a number and should click on the appropriate button. Once you start your application, you will see this table with all the steps listed. A green check means that you have completed that section. A red X that you still need to do the section. You are not finished until all the sections have been checked. First, you will enter your personal information. You'll have to provide contact information, addresses, phone numbers, emails, etc. If you notice this year, you will not be able to select your test date, and I will discuss that more further in. Next, you will select the campus you are applying to. You may select Teterboro, Hackensack, or both. If you select both schools, a message will appear asking you which school is your first choice. When you check on the box next to a school, a window will appear with the choices for majors. You may choose a first and a second choice major for each school. We recommend that all students pick two choices for Teterboro. Please think carefully about what major you would like. Once accepted, we do not allow students to change their majors. Testing dates are Saturday, January 9th, or Sunday, January 10th. Testing will occur online this year. Please clear your calendar for both days between 9:30 and 3 p.m. On December 21st, you will receive an email with an exact day and time for your testing. The next step is to enter your essay. It should be 400 words or less on why you would like to be accepted to your chosen major. This would be about two paragraphs, and we don't recommend the essays be any longer. Do not mention your second choice. It's not necessary. Please do not mention Bergen Academies in your essay. If you are applying to both Hackensack and Teterboro, you will need to write two essays, one for each school. I would suggest working on your computer on the essay, and then when complete, copy and paste it into the website. You may type a couple of words as a placeholder if you'd like to complete the other sections of your application first, but be sure to go back and enter your essay if you chose to do this. You will then need to enter the names of the teachers that will write recommendations for you. Your math recommendation must come from your current 8th grade teacher. Your science and English recommendation may be from your 7th or 8th grade teachers. You can choose which one. Please remember that your recommendations will be kept entirely confidential, and you will not be able to see them. I'll come back to recommendations in a minute, but you will click Save and then continue. At this point, all the information on the student's end has been entered. You will need to review the application. When you click Review, the application will appear in a new window. I would suggest you print your application for your records. If everything is in order, you can click Submit, or you can go back and edit the sections. Once you click Submit, a 6-digit confirmation number will be generated. If you do not see the confirmation number in red, please wait until it appears. Your application is not saved in our system until you see this number. The last thing to do is to print your school forms. There are a number of forms that you will need to print. Clicking the checkbox next to the form name will open the form in a new window. Your photo ID is required. This year, we are asking you to upload a photo or selfie to be used on the testing day. This is part of the application process, and the application will not be complete without this upload. Again, this year, we are asking for 2 copies of the transcript form to be printed and given to your guidance counselor. 1 copy they will return to us with your transcripts, the second is for your counselor's records. Parents must be sure to sign the forms. Your counselors can enter your information online, and if they have any questions, please have them email us directly. You will need to print 1 of each of the 3 recommendation forms. Please print and give these to the appropriate teachers. As a reminder, your math recommendation must be from your current 8th grade teacher. Your science and English recommendations may be from either your 7th or 8th grade teachers. Your teachers will write your recommendations online, but there is a deadline, so be sure to give your teachers plenty of time to complete this, and once again, ask them how they would like to receive this form. The case manager form is only for students with a 504 plan or IEP. These would be students with health and special education needs. It is important that we receive any 504 or IEP documentation before the admissions testing in January so that the student can receive their necessary accommodations. Again, I'd like to point out that students should think carefully about their technical area while applying, because after the application deadline, changes aren't allowed. In general, most students are accepted into their first choice. Every year, students will be more involved in their major, so if it is not an area of interest, students will be unhappy by senior year. As a reminder, these are our important dates. The application deadline is December 14th. The computer system will shut down automatically, and we will not accept any applications after that. I'd recommend filling out your application early. That way, if there is any problem, there is plenty of time to contact us to work it out. The portfolio for commercial art is also due on December 14th. Admissions testing will be held the second weekend in January. After that, you won't hear from us until April. We do not interview students, and letters of admission are usually sent in April. All applicants will be notified by mail with either a yes or no decision. Our district policy is that students may apply to either Teterboro and BCA using the same application, or to Paramus Tech, or to Applied Technology High School, but not to all 4 schools. However, students applying to Teterboro only may opt to have their application forwarded to Applied Tech if they are not accepted. Students must be applying to one of our engineering majors in order to have their application forwarded. A checkbox will appear in the application if the proper criteria are met, and students can select this option. We recommend attending an Applied Tech open house for more information on this school. That basically ends our application process. Here are some answers to some frequently asked questions. The home districts provide all busing. Most likely, there is already a bus route in place. You should call your district's central office with any busing questions. There is an after-school sports bus to bring students to the appropriate campus for their sports team, and we do have a late bus to bring students home after clubs on Tuesdays and Thursdays. There are absolutely no fees for you to apply or attend our school. All tuition is paid by the home school district. Our school has no town quotas. Remember, you are applying with all the applicants across the county, not just in your town. We are often asked how many students typically apply to each major. That number varies greatly from year to year, and even the admissions committee can't predict which major will be most popular during a given year. We are also asked which major is the easiest to get into. This, too, will vary from year to year, depending on the number of applicants per major. Our school does accept students with special education needs. If your child receives accommodations through a 504 plan or IEP, it is very important that the case manager form be submitted by December 14th so that we can give the students their accommodations during admissions testing. Our admissions committee chair, Ms. Pacino, will be happy to answer any questions that you might have. Her contact information is provided above. The best method of contact is email, and you will most likely receive a response within a day. Thank you for taking the time to visit our school. We look forward to seeing your application.